Ohm's law. Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that current through a metallic conductor is directly proportional to potential difference applied across the ends of the conductor, provided the temperature remains constant. This states that potential difference is directly proportional to current. If we plot the graph between current and voltage, we get a straight line. This is a battery eliminator which is operated on 4 volts. It is a DC. This is a battery eliminator which is operated on 4 volts and it provides DC current. Positive terminal indicates the red terminal indicates the positive and the black one indicates the negative terminal. Milliammeter.
Yes.
This is a milliammeter of a range 0 to 500. Its function is to measure the current. It has a very low resistance and always connected in series. This is a voltmeter of the range 0 to 10. It has a very high resistance and it is always connected in parallel with a given resistor whose resistance has to be calculated. Yeah. This is a rheostat. Its function is to vary the current in a circuit. If the value of R increases, the current through a circuit decreases. This is a key which is used to close or open the circuit. If the knob is inserted, then the circuit is closed, and if we remove the knob, the circuit gets disconnected. Connect the circuit to verify the Ohm's law. The positive terminal of the battery is connected to positive of milliammeter. The negative is connected to the voltmeter, positive terminal of voltmeter. Negative is connected to key. The key is connected to the rheostat top terminal. The bottom one is connected to the negative of the battery. And the resistance wire, whose resistance has to be calculated, is connected across the voltmeter. This wire is made up of an alloy, constantin. The property of the alloy is that it has very high resistivity and low coefficient of resistance. As soon as we switch on, the current flows through the circuit. We can see that the needle is showing certain readings. It's around 300. And correspondingly, the voltage has been noted down and it is 0.4 volts. Now we vary this resistance in a rheostat. You can observe that the value of I changes and correspondingly the value of V changes. That is, the V is directly proportional to I. If we plot the graph between voltage and current, we are going to get a straight line. And say, we should not pass the current for our larger coils because the value of resistance changes. If a very large current flows through a given wire, the resistance of the wire changes. As a result, the temperature increases. Joule's heating effect, according to that, the temperature rises and hence the resistance changes.